Bobby Gassimi's story begins almost 3 years ago with the phone call.
Toughest call that any parents can get.
It's about your son. There's been an accident. Come quick.
I told my younger brother to hold his hand. Until I get there.
Bobby's car had careened off a dark and winding road. Paramedics assessed the wreckage and Bobby.
When I'm looking at the reports, they report a Glasgow coma score of 3. A brick or a piece of wood has a Glasgow coma score of 3. It's dead. And somehow the paramedics miraculously managed to revive this kid.
This was the scene when his parents finally arrived to Bobby's bedside.
He realized that he could be going any time.
There had been so much bleeding within the brain. His skull could not contain the swelling. Every part of his brain was affected. But Peter and Marjan Gassimi shrugged off the horror of their situation to fight.
Our motto during the whole time that he was in coma, you fight your way and you come back to us.
Little did they know that that fight would link them to the sole survivor of an infamous mining disaster.
Tonight, 13 coal miners trapped nearly 2 miles inside a West Virginia mine.
A few years before Bobby's car barreled off that road, 13 miners huddled together after an explosion as deadly carbon monoxide crept into the airspace around them. 41 hours later,
the only confirmed survivor is Randall L. McCloy, Jr.
Dr. Julian Bales was Randy McCloy's neurosurgeon.
He had had a massive heart attack from carbon monoxide and methane poisoning. He was in liver failure, kidney failure, had a collapsed lung.
McCloy's body somehow recovered. The question was, could his brain do the same?
Can you quantify the likelihood that someone like a Randall McCloy would recover, that he would have a meaningful neurological recovery?
We felt, and I think everything since then supports the fact that it was truly a long shot.
But Bales was concocting an unorthodox plan to try and save Randy McCloy's brain. High doses of omega-3 fatty acids, fish oil.
So the concept was then trying to rebuild his brain with what it was made from when he was an embryo in his mother's womb.
Rebuild his brain.
Yes. We gave him a very high, unprecedented dose to make sure we saturated and got high levels in the brain.
Had that ever been done before, to your knowledge?
No, it had not.
Bales was going out on a limb, but he had a hunch. In other studies, omega-3 seemed to restore balance in the brain, helping some patients with depression or suicidal thoughts. Could an injured brain be similarly restored? And if so, how?
If you have a brick wall and it gets damaged, wouldn't you want to use bricks to repair the wall? And omega-3 fatty acids are literally the bricks of the cell wall in the brain.
During a traumatic brain injury, the brain swells and nerve cells stop communicating and die. Omega-3 fatty acids, the theory goes, can rebuild damaged nerve cells, reduce inflammation, keep those brain cells from dying. The problem? Few human studies had proven this theory. 10 days after his accident, Bobby Gassimi was still in a coma.
If he ever comes out of the coma, we don't know what kind of shape he's going to be in. And it was really hard to hear that, okay, he lived, he survived, and then now what?
So they saved his life, but we don't have anything that helps from that point forward.
And I would love to have you on the show.
Dr. Michael Lewis, a former Army colonel and omega-3 researcher, believes fish oil could be the missing link.
But ultimately, we need to get it in the scientific literature by doing the good science and the studies to prove it.
After Bobby's accident, he got a desperate call from Peter Gassimi. And after some explaining, asked him,
what do you think about the idea of using high-dose fish oil like Julian Bales used with Randy McCloy?
The carbon monoxide level was really high, and I have no explanation of how I escaped it.
But McCloy, whose remarkable recovery is well known, was just one case. and it remains unclear whether omega-3 was truly the key. The next hurdle for Gassimi? Convincing Bobby's doctors.
It was a fight. They didn't believe, and they said, fine, the West Virginia miner was one case. I need 1,000 cases to be proven for me before I can give this to your son.
He literally had to lay down in the middle of the floor and throw a tantrum until they started to put it down his child's feeding tube.
The tantrum worked. And 2 weeks after starting his fish oil regimen, Bobby Gassimi, case study number two, began to emerge from his coma. About 2 months after that, he attended his high school graduation.
They all stood up and were screaming and chanting my name. I took my graduation cap off and waved it around.
The common denominators for Gassimi and McCloy, devastating brain injuries, and then omega-3 fish oil. But did the omega-3 hasten their recovery? For now, we do not know.
I absolutely believe that it made a huge difference in Bobby's recovery. And this is pure speculation. He never would have come out of a coma if it hadn't been for the use of omega-3s to allow that natural healing process to occur.
Bales and Lewis became paid consultants to fish oil companies after treating McCloy and Gassimi. Since then, they have seen omega-3 work in similar cases, and they believe, taken daily, it could form a lubricant, as they call it, against future brain injury.
Is this a big deal to you?
It is a big deal. There is no known solution. There is no known drug. There's nothing that we have really to offer these sorts of patients.